Hi everyone, I'm Andrew Sermon with Riding the Pine. You may be wondering why I'm standing in the McGurk Arena at 6 a.m. Well, let me tell you, we're here with the CMU dance team, and with the help of my editorial staff, we are going to take on a session with the dance team. Let's dance. Hi guys, I'm here with Coach Amy Bunting. Coach, can you tell us, for people who don't know, what the CMU dance team is?
Well, the CMU dance team is a performance group on campus. We're a part of the athletic department. We perform at all of the home football games and men's and women's basketball games, and some of the away games, especially tournament play.
Okay. Now, you were saying that this is the dance we're learning here today is a 30-second dance. That's something you guys do at halftime of the basketball game. But you know, what else do you guys? You guys said you guys compete. Where else do you guys go?
Well, in the past, we've competed for two different organizations that both have the same parent company that really are the governing body for NCAA College Spirit programs. So cheer and dance usually go down to Florida. It sometimes is Orlando, sometimes it's Daytona Beach. But we compete against all the other D1A schools in our countries. We ended up fifth in the country last year.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Now, you said that there's a lot of hours that goes into the dance, and as we are learning here today, it's not easy. What goes into a dance like this, and then the things that you guys take into competition?
Well, you asked today, one of your fellas asked today, what level of difficulty this would be. And on a scale of 0 to 10, it would be about a 4 for one of our game day performance minis. The main reason for that is because we want it to be very effective and clean. And as you can imagine, a competitive routine in a contemporary or a jazz arena would not be appropriate for a game day. So the material that we use here is mostly a spirited genre, something a little bit more exciting for an athletic event. The hours it takes for us to compete one of our national-based routines is about 200 hours. And we meet starting in the fall, and our competition isn't until April. Yeah.
I'm here with Katie Elsheski, a junior member of the dance team. Katie, you were the choreographer today. What are some tricks of the trade to creating a good dance?
Creating a good dance definitely takes a lot of time. The hardest part of it is finding music that's up to tempo and that the audience is going to enjoy. So oftentimes we look for remixes on YouTube, see what we can get our hands on, popular songs. Other than that, just kind of making sure that it's up to the technique and that we're going to actually really impress our audience. So, yeah.
Now, have you ever been nervous performing, you know, in a competition or just at halftime of basketball games?
I still get nervous the first couple basketball games, you know, just the butterflies. But, I mean, if you're not nervous, then that's kind of weird. You need to definitely put your best foot forward. So,
Now, why did you join the CMU dance team? If you have a story about your tryout or anything like that, when did you join?
I joined my incoming freshman year. So before I came to CMU, I actually that summer tried out for the dance team. And I danced my entire life, and I was just looking to get connected at CMU, meet a good group of girls that I could feel comfortable going in with. So this definitely made my transition from high school to college a whole lot easier. We're all very close. We really believe in teamwork. So it's been great to be on this team.
Awesome. Thanks, Katie.
Thank you.
We both just learned a brand new dance, our squad and their squad. We're going to have a dance off here, and we're going to see how it goes.